Battersea Power Station, which provided London's electricity for 50 years, now has a future, albeit a controversial one. Lying derelict since 1979, areas like the Art Deco Turbine Room await the prospect of a Disney-style regeneration to turn it from redundant power station into a massive leisure park by 1990. Protected as a listed building, many original features will have to be retained. Outside, its famous shape will be unchanged. But architects' imaginations have been working overtime on a main hall the size of an 18-storey building.
Oh, it's in every Londoner's imagination. He knows Battersea Power Station as well as he knows St Paul's Cathedral. He's got that image in his mind. But he'll be absolutely enthralled when he comes inside.
The developers, Battersea Leisure, have £135 million promised by a Canadian bank and agreement with BR to put in a direct rail link from Victoria. That should turn dreams into reality, dreams which began with their development of Britain's premier leisure park at Alton Towers in Staffordshire.
Well, it's theatres and cinemas and high-tech entertainment, restaurants of the type, you know, the very latest in the world, such as simulators and computer golf and quite a lot of amazing high-tech entertainment.
Ambitions which rely on the removal of tons of dangerous asbestos inside the building and, ironically, the restoration of electricity supplies. They're also likely to ride roughshod over local objections.
We are in business not to antagonise or to disturb or upset the local area or residents, but indeed to toe in with the whole general area. I mean, it's interesting to note, for example, that in the immediate area of our scheme, since we announced it, property prices have gone up in leaps and bounds.
But residents fear traffic will do the same if there are over 3 million visitors a year. They also argue Battersea Leisure will buy off Wandsworth Council rather than set aside space for the local community.
And we believe for the largest scheme like this in inner London for the last decades, which will generate millions of people, that there should be a public inquiry where many of these issues could be properly thrashed out.
The developers promise over 4,000 jobs as a sweetener, but whether you view the power station affectionately as an upturned table or less enthusiastically as an upturned white elephant, its distinctive lines should be a London landmark for years to come. Marcus Powell for Thames News.